Hello, I'm Randy here again, and we're playing Farming Simulator 15 on Pleasant Valley Rivers. Yes, the long-awaited Pleasant Valley Rivers map. We are playing on the RD Allen multiplayer server, and joined at the moment by Buggy, Chase, and Bull. Server's been up for, I would say, probably less than 24 hours. It might be about 24 hours now. And I've already got $1.3 million. So, yes, you could say we've been successful so far. Don't believe we've picked up a whole lot of new equipment yet. Pretty much just got most of the basic starting equipment plus the equipment we found. So, first off, for those who want to join us on Pleasant Valley Rivers, links are in the description below. For all the mods you will need. At the moment, we just have the basic mods that come with Pleasant Valley. Don't have any additional mods. And there's going to be two download links. The first download link is just going to download all the mods that are on the server. The second download link will let you folks download the mods individually. So if you need like one or two mods, you can use that link. And we're just kind of going to drive around the map here. Just check it out here for... Whoa, this thing is... Yeah, so we can climb right up hills with this. Okay. Thing's a little squirrely to drive, apparently. This is one of the mods here that come with the Pleasant Valley mod pack, by the way. I was looking through the vehicles. It's like, oh, I need a kind of a nice vehicle just to drive around and show you folks the map here. It's like, oh, yes, I've got to get one of these things. There was something else I was going to get, but it's like, no, that's a bad idea. Bad idea. So we'll get this. Whoa, 102? Oh my goodness. Maybe this wasn't such a good idea to get. No wonder why we're having trouble driving. Anyway, folks, like I was saying about the mods, mod links are in the description below. Also, we do have a TeamSpeak server. TeamSpeak server information is in the description of this video as well. So, episode one here of Pleasant Valley Rivers. And just to show you folks the map, wow, look at all that stuff going on. A lot of stuff going on here on this map, so not sure where to even start, really. Maybe we'll just kind of like do a circle around the map or something, and we'll start actually doing some work here. We started out there. We were kind of by the Shell station. That's where the shop is. When you start this map, you do have to make your own seeds, your own fuel, and your own fertilizer. So the map does come with the crops planted that you need to start with. We currently own 8, 9, and 16. I don't think there's any other fields we own that I know of. That's down at the South Farm there. We've already harvested those crops, and they've probably been replanted a couple of times by now, I'm guessing. Also, we're going to do a spin again. Also important to note, the map has actually been updated. Apparently, I think I'm actually using the older version of this map at the moment. Some of the bugs have been fixed. And there is actually a new version out already. Go figure, as soon as I get the server up, there's already a new version out. That's kind of one reason, folks, I kind of was going to wait a little bit to do a Pleasant Valley server, because like I know they're going to be fixing bugs at first, and we'll just be like updating maps constantly. Yeah, as you can see, lots of fields. None of the fields, you know, strike me as like being huge fields, just nice, good-sized fields, I would say. Seems like a pretty nice layout. There are four farms. You got the South Farm. Let's see, North Farm is up there somewhere. I'm not seeing where it is on the map at the moment. Then we got the East Farm and West Farm, I believe is how it's laid out. So yeah, South Farm, West Farm. I'm not seeing the North Farm right off the top of my head here. I'm pretty sure it's the North Farm, they call it. And then there's the East Farm over on the east side there. More of the Northeast Farm, I would say. But from what I've seen so far, I think it's going to be somewhat similar to what Pleasant Valley was. Just going to be probably a lot more. It has the same menu as the previous map, Gift of the Caucasus map here. So it has this same menu system. You access that by pushing the question mark key, at least on US keyboards anyway. So for those of you with US based keyboards, it is the question mark key. I know on the previous map there it said it was the period key. It is actually the question mark. The question slash slash key is the key it is. And then shift question mark brings up this whole map, and we can, I guess we can buy fields. So that's 160,000. That's not too bad. What do we got? 446,000. Let's see. What is a big field here? Almost a million. Not quite 1,900,000. So yeah, it looks like fields are definitely a little bit cheaper here on this map. Looks like, again, the previous map, they definitely felt proud of their fields and factories on that map. Bloody expensive. Well, looks like we got the lumber yard here. Ooh, two places to put lumber. Or to make lumber, I should say. Oh, yeah, so we got the Brooks chipper. To be honest, folks, that mod might disappear. Just my opinion. That's just a little OP, but for those who don't know what OP is, overpowered. Looks like we got a couple forage wagons up here. Dump logs here. Oh, is this another wood chip? Okay, or lumber? I'm actually not sure what this one is. Looks like this is more for wood chips. Anyway, all stuff, like I said, folks, to figure out. Guess I can't go out that way. And as far as I know, this is the forestier area on the map here. Pretty cool, a little winding through the woods here. Probably not so, oh, there's a mud pit, yes. Don't forget the mud pits, folks. I was going to mention that. Kind of a nice winding area through the forest here. Anyway, not much else to see in here than other than, you know, trees and more trees and even more trees. Just continue our way around here. Like I said, we'll maybe try to make a circle around the map here. Hopefully it won't take more than a couple minutes, and then we'll try to find something more productive to do. I don't know there's a whole lot else to see on this side of the map, other than maybe the speedway. Okay, everyone, we're back here again and joined by DJ. We just went past the water tower there. Looks like, again, very similar to Pleasant Valley. You first have to have the Culligan water plant going. And then you can fill that. I'm assuming there's probably multiple water towers around the map. Oh, how do you turn off parking brake? Yes, important thing to note there. We do have drive control mod on the server at the moment. Not sure if that's going to stay or not. I guess we'll see what people say. Probably one of the at least more annoying parts for me is the shuttle control. I don't particularly care for that. Turn off spacebar. U. It should be control space, unless I'm mistaken. I might have my controls changed. I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure I have the default controls, but I could be wrong on that. Whee, okay, this is, yeah, fun to drive. I'm gonna try to get to that bridge over there if I can. And somewhere on this map, I believe there is a bridge you have to build. I'm not sure where that is. This VW here kind of reminds me of the trucks when Farming Simulator first came out a little bit. Really squirrely to drive. It's probably not so bad because we are going pretty good clip here. I haven't seen it get up to 102 yet, though. Probably a good thing, actually. Oh, here we are at the speedway. Looks pretty similar to the one on Pleasant Valley. we can make it there anyway. Oh, is the VW going to fit under here? It might not. Yeah, I don't think it will. Nope, we're stuck. Yep, we're stuck good, folks. Oh, unless I do, if I do this. Oh, it does not have four-wheel drive or diff locks. Interesting. Oh, well. What we can probably do, folks, is just sell it. It'll probably cost me more to reset it than it will if I buy a new one. We're just going to sell that. Probably a good thing anyway. Let's see. Is there anything else in the map we wanted to see? Wow, that was interesting. Now I'm stuck in the fence. Okay. That's weird. Let's see. Anything else? Oh, I did want to go up by the quarry there. Maybe we'll buy another something. As you can see, quite a few mods that come with Pleasant Valley. There's a couple harvesters, some tippers, a lot of AR stuff. Supposedly the AR stuff is supposed to be better for multiplayer. It doesn't create as much lag on the multiplayer server when you start getting a lot of vehicles, supposedly. Something to do with wheels. It does come with a Krone Ultima. Again, I debated getting rid of this mod because, like I said, in the past, we've had some multiplayer issues with it. So probably not the best of mods to have, but we do have it. Some headers, some tractors. I've been told the Class Xeron 4500 here is a really nice tractor. At least that's what I've been told anyway. I think I might actually have that one single player. I don't know that I've ever used it, though. We do have this truck. I know I've had this truck before. There's something wrong with it, and I don't remember what. Hopefully it's been fixed. Because I did download that that Big Daddy truck there before. Took a look at it. It's like, nope, getting rid of this one. And I don't remember why now. Let's see, telehandlers, yep. It does come with the IT modded hook lift pack. This isn't the same as the IT Runner DLC, but some very similar equipment. Comes with a couple big sewing machines. Like I said, folks, I have not added in the mods I normally add in for the multiplayer server. These are just the mods that come with Pleasant Valley. So typically like the big cedars I add in, those are not here. These are the cedars that come with Pleasant Valley and its mod packs. So working with a 30 meters, yeah, well, I guess, whatever. Anyway, let's back there, let's purchase something. Let's just visit the quarry here a moment. I'm going to go to cars. I was going to buy a go-kart. Like I said, folks, I'm not sure it's the wisest of things to buy. Let's get a nice bright red one. Okay, folks, I'm predicting hang on to her. So, for those who've never used drive control before, enter starts your vehicle. Control space takes off the parking brake. And then you got the shuttle control. Now, for me, I've got it configured to control shift space. We'll get rid of the shuttle control. I don't know if there's a default for it or not, but that's what I've got. Whoa, that's a river there. Let's not go that way. Okay, this thing drives about as well, or doesn't drive as well as the Volkswagen did. Maybe not such a good idea here. Whoa, it goes fast though. Yeehaw. Folks might want to hang on to your socks here, because this could be an interesting ride. Oh, no horn. Bummer. Oh, yes. Okay, it's kind of fun to drive, folks. It's a little annoying in some ways, but... Okay, I do want, like I said, I want to get up by the... This may not have been the way to go. Well, folks, if it's the wrong way to go, you know what we can do? This is probably going to... Oh, man, come on now, I can't even make it. Oh, you know what? I think there is ground response. That's what's probably giving me some trouble in these fields here. I'm like, why can I not drive in this field? Come on, I want to get out of the field. Out of the field. Whoa, you kind of just catch the edge and it just spins you around. Like I said, that might be part of the ground response. Whoa. Ground response from drive control there. Maybe this wasn't such a good idea to buy this. Maybe I should have bought the Volkswagen again. I figured it'd be a little bit quicker. And yeah, it's definitely quicker, folks. See if I can actually do this better with a keyboard, maybe. Now, let's see. How do I get out of here? I don't know if I can go around this way or not. Yeah, it looks like I can. Oh, what do we got here? Future home of Frito-Lay. Okay, so we got the Frito-Lay factory again. And I'm assuming it's going to be somewhat similar to the way Pleasant Valley was there. You got to bring whatever the required items are. Probably three stages of production. You know, three stages. You have to bring whatever is required for that stage. And then the place will get built. And then you can use the place for whatever. Oh, I should have stayed on the road. Not a good idea. Not a good idea. We're almost to the quarry, though. Almost there. In fact, I believe that is in the distance there, the quarry. The steering on this thing, folks, you're driving along, you don't even turn, and it just starts going crazy. I haven't even bumped. So I'm using my keyboard here at the moment to drive this. I'm just pushing straight on the W key, and it's just weird. Oh, well. Yep, definitely should have got the Volkswagen. I think we're going to ditch this thing up here somewhere, and we'll just leave it. Someone else can find it and get sick from it. Whee! Also, you can't look any further down than this. This is actually as far down as I can look. I'm assuming the quarry here is probably the same way as it was in Pleasant Valley. You gotta go dig it out, fill it up in the hopper, and then you can fill your trucks with it. And, you know, pretty much repeat the process. It looks like it was stone there. What do we got here? Or was it coal? That was coal, right? That coal, and then this is the gravel. Probably sand, gravel, coal, stone. Let's see, what else was there? That might have been it. Doesn't say what that one is. Okay. So whatever that is. I can't quite tell. Anyway, folks, let's see if we can find something a little more serious to do here. Oh, we do it. The loader, by the way, I was just going to say we have a loader. The loader we found, by the way, I forget where that was. Don't think I really mentioned it that much, but there are hidden vehicles on this map. I'm not sure how many of the hidden vehicles we found, but we have found a few. I found the fertilizer spreader and a plow. Plow, probably not so useful. The fertilizer, yeah, that's probably somewhat useful. I don't know if we've got any fertilizer made yet or not. I'm assuming we do. So over here you have the Seed Master, which is the green one, and the fertilizer. The blue one there. This makes seeds. As far as I know, you can dump, but actually it says. Looks like you can dump any type of seed in here and it'll make seeds for you. And then you got the Fertilizer Master. Input manure, liquid manure, or compost to make fertilizer. I believe we were making it with a straw from what I was told, so I'm guessing we're making compost from the straw, and then the compost goes into the Fertilizer Master. And fuel is made at the shell plant, as far as I know. And unless they change the recipe, I believe that was sorghum, sugarcane, and corn. At least that's what it was in Pleasant Valley. Like I said, they may have changed the recipe. I'm not sure, but that is what it was in Pleasant Valley. Not sure what that is right off the top of my head. And it was definitely sorghum over here from the looks of it. I'm guessing that's probably for fuel production. Let's see, not sure what we got going on over here. If Chase was planting. If not, maybe we can continue doing some planting here. That is one dirty tractor. Okay, let's get it fired up. And like I said again, drive control, enter. And then control space bar to take off the parking brake. I'm fairly used to playing with it because I play with it single player, so it doesn't bother me none particularly. The only thing I don't like is the shuttle, which once you turn it off, it stays off. At least it probably will until we restart the server or the server crashes anyway. And then as far as I know, it probably has crop destruction as well, I would assume. Unless it's an older version. I'm not sure. I didn't actually check what version this is. Oh, I don't own this. Oh, this is 17. Okay. Ah, we need some more fields. Yes, that would actually come in handy. Maybe we'll see if we can purchase 17 here. That seems like a good field to buy. I think one of these fields wasn't planted here, wasn't it? Let's double check. Ah, field 8 is not planted. Okay. We'll head over there then. And field 9 is obviously being harvested. Looks like Buggy is working on that one. And I think we'll go up and down the field this way because field 9 there is pretty close. Yeah, we definitely don't need all that stuff on. We'll just leave the four-wheel drive on. As far as I know, when you leave that on, it actually takes more fuel, so it is actually of some benefit to actually turn that off, to my knowledge. Not that it particularly matters. Oh, we need straw. Okay. Let this plant... Oh, I can't change it? Really? Let's see. Do I need to be next to a fertilizer? Or not a fertilizer, a seed master. I'm guessing you do, because I don't see the option to change it, so I'm assuming we got to do it the same way we did on the previous map. You have to be at a seed refill point to actually be able to plant, or to actually be able to change the seed type. At least I'm hoping that's what the problem is. I'm not sure. We'll find out. Okay, I don't appear to be getting any options for anything here. Oh, there we go. We can refill. Okay, but I still cannot change seed type. Well, why is that? See if I'm missing something here. Unload it and choose. Okay, that's what I was thinking. Did I miss the unload option, though? Oh, I wonder if you gotta unload in the front, maybe. Unfold. Detach. Pulling back. Oh, to unload. Okay, pulling back. Okay. Definitely missing something here because I'm not seeing the option to unload. I can detach, okay. See if we can get back under the spout again. I don't think that's where you would unload, but. Nope. Let's see. Buggy said pulling back and hit O. I'm assuming he means the Seedmaster. Oh, seed shed. Okay. That would make sense. So you can fill out the seed master, you just can't change at the seed master. Okay. So you got to be at the seed shed. And he said the back, so I'm assuming back here. Fill. Oh, okay. Fill seeds right there. Okay, there we go. So again, very similar to our previous map. Actually, almost identical. And of course, I got it full, so it's going to take a moment to reload here. That is the one complaint I do have about this. It takes forever to unload, folks. Okay, seeds are finally unloaded there. Now we can select a seed. And let's see what's here. Buggy said he wanted something with straw, so. Oats will produce straw as far as I know. So will rye. We'll just do wheat, I guess, just to be safe. And then refill the sower. That should be enough seed, I think. Seems how if we want to chain seed, we got to empty it, so no sense filling it up all the way. Okay, let's get it folded back out here, turn it on, and start seeding. Let's see, 9.7 meters. I think that seems a little wide. Yeah, it's working, though. We'll go with it. As long as we don't get too much space in between, we should be good. And yeah, like I was saying, it looks like we have enough money, so see if we can buy one of the larger fields here, like 17 or something like that. Definitely think we have enough money for one of those, so. Anyway, folks, looking at time, looks like it's time to wrap up the episode here already. And just a reminder again, if folks want to join us on the Pleasant Valley Rivers here, links are in the description below for the mods needed to join the server. Also a TeamSpeak server. Information is in the description below of this video as well for that. And the server is located under International, by the way. For those of you wondering where it's located, it is under International. Just search for RD Allen. Should be the only server that comes up. So yeah, with that, folks, if you folks have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. And as always, thanks for watching, and till next time.